Today we're going to speak about the month of Tammuz. It's very strange that we call a month after a Babylonian idol. You look in Sefer Yecheskel, Tammuz is the name of a Babylonian pagan idol. So why in the world would we name a fast and a month, Abraham, after a pagan idol? Exodus 23 tells us, V'shem Elohim Acherim Lo Tazkiru. The name of a getchke you should not mention. Lo Yishom Al Picha. Exodus 23 says, you're not allowed to mention the name of Avodah Zarah. So how could you say Shivosa B'Tammuz? Can't mention J.C. Penney's name. So the Talmud Sanhedrin 63 asked that question, David. And the Talmud answers, okay, you can't mention the name of an idol, but if the idol's already written in Tanakh, it's kosher. For instance, Baal, Molech. How do you mention Baal and Molech? Baal Peor, Tammuz. So if the idol's mentioned in Tanakh, then what? It's kosher to say. But there's still no mitzvah to say it. This week's parsha, the Jews commit paganism and harlotry with the Baal Peor. How can you say the name of the getchke Baal Peor? So the Talmud Sanhedrin 63 says, if the idol is mentioned in Tanakh, then you could say it. Isn't it bizarre that we would name a fast and a month after the idol Tammuz, which is in Yecheskel mentioned as an idol? And why you named it the fast after? Next Sunday, Shivosa B'Tammuz. So if the Avodah Zarah is in Tanakh, you can mention it. If it's not in Tanakh, you can't mention it. So if I say J.C. Penney, right? Mm-hmm. But I'll mention the name. But again, why would we name a month after an idol? So if you take a look at side number one, sheet number one, it's a strange Gemara here. This is on Tractate Yom, it's on the left side. I think it's highlighted in yellow. On side number one of them. You have that?
Yeah.
You should have two papers clipped together. You have it?
Yeah.
Good. Side number one on the left side. Resh Lakish. See that? Resh Lakish, one of the great sages of the Talmud, who happened to be a Baal Tshuva. Resh Lakish, the Talmud in Bavitzia said he used to be like Meir Lansky. Or Bugsy Siegel.
Really?
Yep. And he became... And he became a Baal Tshuva because of what? Pretty woman walking down the street. You know the Gemara in Bava Metzia, 87. Resh Lakish, your Berachon says to him, what are you wasting you're such a bright guy. What are you wasting your time on nonsense? Come to my yeshiva, and I'll give you my sister as a kala. And she's Miss Universe. Mm-hmm. So guess what happened? He took him up on the offer. Became a great Baal Tshuva, the great Resh Lakish, one of the greatest sages of the Talmud, all because of what? Pretty woman. Isn't that incredible? For a pretty face, Elisheva, he became the great sage. Oh, that's right, that's right. I think it was Roy Orbison. Pretty woman, right? Don't mix me up. Okay? Pretty woman's a mate, Resh Lakish, so the great sage Resh Lakish tells us he was the chief rabbi of Tveria, by the way. Havasoche b'yardana. You just have him. Follow me along. He was taking a bath in the Jordan River. Also, Rabba Bar Bachana, you see that? Who came to visit him? The chief rabbi of Babylon, Long Island. Rabba Bar Bachana from Babylon. He came to visit him, and he saw the great Resh Lakish was bathing in the Nahr. Yahavle Yoda. What does it mean, Avram? Yahavle Yoda. I have it in Hebrew there. Nosan loy Rabba Barbachana Yad Resh Lakish. So the chief rabbi of Babylon, Long Island, gave a hand to the great sage Resh Lakish to help him out of the Jordan River. Mm. Right? Omele, what did Resh Lakish say to Rabba Barbachana?
I hate
you. Allah. Wow. What does Allah mean? By God. Sanon Elacha. I hate you, or God hates you, Babylonians. That's how you talk? God hates you, or I hate you, you Babylonians. What?
Didn't give enough tzedakah.
Lefish and Nishartem Bebovel Bezman Elias Ezra. Because you guys remained in Babylon, Long Island, when Ezra came to call. We're building a second temple. Come on up. The vast majority of Jews remained in Babylon and Persia. You hear this? Look at footnote 36. I think it's highlighted in yellow. Footnote 36. You see that, Evelyn? Ba'ali Arishona, of the millions of Jews in Babylon and Persia, how many came up with Ezra? 42,360.
Something.
Millions remained in Borough Park, I mean in Babylon. You hear? Vast majority of people remained in Babylon. If you read the book of Ezra, Ezra Busha Becherpa Avram. The temple was standing, there wasn't enough Kahanim and Levites to administer in the Beis HaMikdash. So Ezra HaSofer, you know what he did, Avram? He had to take a fast camel or donkey to Babylon Island, put an ad in the Jewish press. Kahanim and Levites wanted to administer the temple. Eze busha v'cherpa. And they didn't want to leave the comforts of Tinek, I mean Babylon. They remained behind. So therefore, Rish Lakish says, I hate you, Babylonians. Why? Dichsiv, take a look. The Pasuk in Shir HaShirim. Im chomahi nivne leo tiras kosef. If the Jewish people come back like a mighty, powerful wall, then the second temple will be a structure made out of silver. Silver doesn't rot, doesn't decay. Vimdeleti, but if the Jewish people come back like a schlepper, dal, in trips and drabs, notzeolei ruach orez, then the second temple will be like a wooden bungalow. The second temple was a wooden hut compared to the first temple. So now the Gemara explains. See that? Im elu asitem atzmen kachoma, if the Jewish people would have come back under Ezra from Babylon like a mighty wall, ve'alitem kulchem yachad dimei Ezra li'eretz Yisrael, when Ezra came to call, you people would have come back and made aliyah, nimshalten, you be compared to kakesef. The second temple would be compared to silver. She'ein rokav sholet bo. The silver rot and decay, Sam? It remains forever. So the second temple would have been what? Forever. V'la'item chasei rav shoy shchina b'bayit. It is. Turn the page over, please. Side number two. Achshav, now. Shialitem kadalsa, you came up like a doll, like schleppers. Therefore, nimshaltem ke'eres, therefore the second temple was like a wooden bungalow. And after 420 years, it what? Destroyed. Look at footnote 39. I think it's highlighted in yellow. You don't know?
Yes.
They call me mellow yellow. Footnote 39, Rashi says, quotes from Ben Yilokum, v'litem golim shuv goz hacheret. If the Jewish people would have come back as a mighty wall from Babylon on the days of Ezra, the second temple, Daniel, never would have been destroyed. You hear me? Mashiach would have come 2,400 years ago. That means no Chelemensky massacre, no Spanish Inquisition, and no Holocaust. But no. You remain behind in Babylon. You didn't want to come up with Ezra. See, I'm reading footnote 39, Yehuda. The Medrash, Eli Yisrael, Ela Choyma, Bibavel, if the Jewish people would have come up like a mighty wall from Bavel, Lo Chore Beit HaMikdash, the second temple never would have been what? You hear me? But the temple is standing in all of its glory. There wasn't even enough Kohanim to administer the temple. Eze Chil Hashem that was. Ezra had to go back to Babylon, Long Island, put an ad in the Jewish press. Not a joke. Read the book of Ezra. Kohanim wanted to run the temple. Isn't that a humiliation for God and Eretz Yisrael in the temple? And therefore, the second temple was destroyed. Therefore, Rish Lakish held a grudge against what? The chief rabbi of Babylon. Because if you guys would have made aliyah when you could have, the second temple never would have been destroyed.
It never happened today.
What?
Never happened today, the dispute between the rabbis here and the rabbis off.
No, oh, what's changed in 2,000 years, Joseph? You still have dispute between the chief rabbi of Israel and the chief rabbi of America. No, I'm still. So nothing much has changed, what? Why are they still in America? America's Amreka, from Amrake. America, I'm right.
Rabbi.
What?
Rabbi.
Now what has changed? Has anything changed? What?
Same thing happened to the city of Gomes.
Right.
Where Hashi
did.
Sent to Gomes.
Ezra sent an SMS to the Jews of Worms, Germany. Yes. Make Aliyah.
And they refused.
They said, we're comfortable here. We have a pizza shop and a koilel here in Germany. We'll remain here. And therefore, the first community to be massacred in the Crusades was the city of Worms. Because they refused to make Aliyah. They said, Ezra, you stay where you are. We'll stay where we are. We have a pizza shop. We have a koilel and a mikveh. Don't bother. We have an Erev Avram. They have an Erev Tinek. Have an Eric and Tina.
But
things changed. What?
But many of us are living here today because of the life.
Yeah.
The opportunities we have in America.
Yes, but now there's a time to make Aliyah. You have the base. You have Eretz Yisrael in all of its glory, and the very fact that Jews remain behind is a chil Hashem. Yecheskel says the very fact that Yidden remain in Galus is a chil Hashem. Look at Yecheskel 37, Avram. God says the very fact that Jews remain in Shmutz Laretz instead of being here, that's a chil Hashem. Have things changed? No. Turn the sheet, but fasten your seat belts. See the last sheet? This is the voice of reason, David. Not the voice of treason. The voice of reason addressed by whom, David?
Jacob
Blaustein. The American Jewish Committee. April 1950, this is the chief of the AJC, the chief of the chief rabbis of the conservative movement in America, AJC, American Jewish Committee. And what does he say? Anybody want to read it? Since Israel now is a state, this is written in 1950, even those originally opposed to it, like the Reform Conservative, are very anti. But what can we do now it's a state? Must realize the necessity and desirability of what?
Helping it to make
a viable, self-supporting state. This for the good of Israel itself and the good of the world. But America is our home. Avram, who says this? J Street. I mean the AJC. America is our home. As the Jews said in Berlin, Berlin is our home. Avram, you read the Or Sameach, the Mesha Chochma, and Pashas Bichikotai. Your hair will stand up, Professor. He wrote this in 1902. In Pashas B'Chikotai, the Mesha Chochma, the Or Sameach. In 1902, he wrote that those Jews that say Berlin is the new Jerusalem, they will bring a Holocaust on the Jewish people. Now, he wrote this in 1902. Hitler didn't come to power to 33, Chava. Look at the Mesha Chochma and Pashas B'Chikotai in the Teuchacha. Jews in 1902 were saying that Berlin is the new Jerusalem. We pray to Berlin now, not to Jerusalem.
Was the Reform movement started in Berlin?
That attitude, said the Mesha Chochma, will bring a Holocaust. He said the word Shoah in 1902. But they said the same thing in 1950 even in America, and they're still saying
Rabbi,
it.
Who said that, Rabbi? Where is that written in 1902? Who said that?
The Mesha Chochma. How do you say that in English? The Mesha Chochma is a parish on Chumash, the Or Sameach, Remeya Simcha Bedevinsk. You know Alfie, one of our students, his mother, Joseph, got a bracha from the Or Sameach. She was, I think, 12 years old, Avram.
Wow.
Meidel is Ostalank Leben.
Wow.
She lived to be over 102.
Wow.
Alfie Zinn from South Africa.
Alfie's mother.
His mother got a bracha from the Remeya Simcha in 1926, the year that he died. He said, Meidel is Ostalank Leben. She lived to be 102. But anyway, this great tzaddik in Or Sameach and Pashas B'Chikotai in the Mesha Chochma writes that those Jews that say that our new home, our new capital, our new Jerusalem is Berlin, will lo yaleinu bring a Holocaust on the Jewish people. How did he know, Avram, in 1902? This tzaddikim have Ruach HaKodesh, but that's what they said. The Reform movement said Berlin is the new Jerusalem. But look what they said in 1950. This is the president of the AJC, Rabbi Jacob Blaustein, rabbi in quotation marks. America is our home. You see this? America is our home. You have it, Judah. American Jews, young and old alike, Zionists and non-Zionists alike, you have this, David, are profoundly attached to this. What's this?
Their country.
My country is America. You have one, Daniel, looking at them. America welcomed our immigrant parents in their need. Under America's free institutions, they and their children have achieved that freedom and sense of security unknown for long centuries of travail. We have truly become Americans. We have truly become Americans, just as have all other oppressed groups that have ever come to these shores. Look at the next paragraph, Yehuda. We repudiate vigorously the suggestion that that American Jews are in exile. They're not in exile anymore. That's what they said in Germany. We're not in exile anymore. We repudiate vigorously the suggestion that American Jews are in exile. The future of American Jewry, this is a rabbi talking. The future of American Jewry.
What type of rabbi is
it? This is a conservative rabbi.
A conservative.
The future of American Jewry, of our children and of our children's children, is entirely linked with what? With the future of America. We have no alternative and we want no alternative.
Wow.
Ooh. It's the DNA syndrome all over again. Who's DNA? Dasan and Aviram. That's what they said. We don't need Eretz Yisrael. Mitzrayim is better. It's the DNA syndrome all over again. Look at the next paragraph, David. You have that? Knowing that nationalists are trying to capture... Who are the nationalists?
People who love Eretz Yisrael.
Are trying to capture the Zionist movement and indoctrinate. It is indoctrinate Jews generally. To live in Israel, you're indoctrinated. You hear this? We propose, among other things, Yehuda, what? To make studies from time to time to determine the extent and intensity of nationalistic attitudes among American Jews. Don't love Israel so much. Exactly. And on the basis of these studies, to take such measures currently as seen appropriate to counteract which attitudes, Avram? This is the American Jewish Committee, but Kowinky Dinky, Yehuda, last week, the American Jewish Committee did a poll. How do I know? Thanks to Yehuda, I get the Jerusalem Post. And the AJC poll, American Jewish Committee, found that 47%, David, 47% of United States Jews oppose the U.S. Embassy move to Jerusalem.
Oh, yeah.
And they don't recognize Jerusalem as our capital. Should I repeat that?
No.
The American Jewish Committee did a poll last week. 47% of U.S. Jews oppose the U.S. Embassy move to Jerusalem.
Uh-oh.
And they do not recognize Jerusalem as our capital.
Yeah.
Hello? Avram, it's the DNA syndrome all over again. Dasan the Aviram syndrome. What?
Oh, this speech was made in 1950?
Read. You have it in front of you. 1950. But last week, the same AJC did a poll that 47% of U.S. Jews oppose Israel. They oppose Jerusalem as our capital.
It's not their business.
Isn't that incredible? Huh?
Yeah.
So it's not just these Jews, but unfortunately, a few weeks ago in New York, some so-called Satmar Hasidim rented out the Nassau Coliseum to slander the state of Israel.
Wow.
No, I don't.
They dressed like Hasidim. Nassau Coliseum, where'd they get the money from, Yehuda? They got together, and guess which parsha they got together to slander Israel? Parsha Shlach. Kowinky Dinky, Professor. Hundreds of Satmar Hasidim,
you know,
rented the Nassau Coliseum, and Parsha Shlach, they spoke the language of what? Of the Meraglim. They slandered the land of Israel. They said, Eretz Ochelos Yoshveha.
No.
The land kills its innocent citizens. That's what the Meraglim said, and that's what these so-called Hasidic Jews. The land of Israel kills its innocent citizens. Yiddish? I think it's called fake news.
Fake news. It's probably fake news.
But they were dressed in a shtreimel and a kapata.
It's probably Probably Goyim dressed up like
that. Huh? No. The Vilna Gaon said, listen what the Vilna Gaon said in 1790.
I wish it were true.
The sin of the spies, says the Vilna Gaon, the sin of the spies is in every generation.
No.
The Vilna Gaon, even the guardians of Torah, says the Vilna Gaon in 1790, will not realize that they are guilty of the sin of the spies.
Right.
When they speak negatively about Eretz Yisrael. How did the Vilna Gaon know in 1790 about the spies rally in the Nassau Coliseum the week of Parshas Shlach?
He read Kabbalah.
Huh?
Because it's
And the Vilna Gaon said, don't be fooled by their religious garb in 1790. Don't be fooled by the Shtraimel and the Kapata. He says the spies were all Rosha B'nai Yisrael. The spies were all Rosha B'nai Yisrael, chief rabbis.
Rosha
B'nai Yisrael. Rosha, they were all Rava Roshi.
Right.
So this is the Vilna Gaon in 1790. The Chassam Sofer, who died in 1839, was also Haredi, writes on Parshas Shlach, those who reject the land of Israel, no matter how they dress, reject God himself.
That's it.
Beware of God-believing heresy. Yeah. Avraham. The more things change, the more they what?
Stay the same.
They stay the same.
Yeah.
But the Rebbe himself was not like
that. But to use the language of the spies, they say the land kills its innocent citizens. That's what the Maragdim said. Eretz Achel Yisrael, and the rally in the Nassau Coliseum, the rally was held Parshas Shlach. Could that be a coinkidinky? Reb Shalom, Parshas Shlach.
Maybe they made their own sentence.
Mm-hmm.
You know, saying it that.
So we don't understand. So getting back to why is the month called Tammuz? Why is the month called Tammuz? So you go back to page number 2. Why is the month called Tammuz? My own handwriting says Rabbi Yehuda Halevi. You see, Rabbi Yehuda Halevi in my handwriting?
No? Levy,
Rabbi Yehuda Halevi, not Rabbi Yehuda Lev. In my handwriting, Avram, you have it?
Here, number two.
Here? Yeah, it says Rabbi Yehuda Halevi, Rabbi Yehuda Lev.
Right here.
Explains why Mashiach did not come after the Nes Purim. All the Jews became Haredi. Kibul v'kibla Yehudim Sherry. All the Jews became Haredi. Why didn't Mashiach come after Nes Purim? So Lubavitch says, because the Rebbe was not born yet.
Ah, there you go.
That's what they say, not a joke, that's what they say. The Rebbe wasn't born yet. But really, 24 years ago, the Megillah testifies, Chavei Kimu V'Kiblu HaYehudim, all the Jews became Haredi. So why didn't Mashiach come?
Because they didn't.
Said Yehuda Levi, God was ready to bring Mashiach if the Jews of Persia, Babylon, Long Island would have then come to Eretz Yisrael. But only a few returned, while the majority and the leaders, even Mordechai and Esther, they remained behind in Shushan. I think it's called Hamadan. Hamadan. So even Mordechai and Esther remained in Persia, preferring to serve Achashverosh and unwilling to leave their fancy houses and their affairs. And therefore, God's name is not in the Megillah. Why is God's name not in the Megillah, Avraham? What? Because the Jews didn't want to come back to Eretz Yisrael. So God's, that's right. If you reject Eretz Yisrael, you reject God. Should I repeat that, Mindel?
Yes.
Not me, the Chassam Sofer in 1839. Yes. If you reject Eretz Yisrael, you reject God. And therefore, Sherry, God's name is the only book in Tanakh that ain't got what? God's name in it. Because they did tshuva, but they remained behind the Bavel and Poras. So God says, you reject Eretz Yisrael, you reject me, I'm out of here. So therefore, God's name, Yehuda, is the only book in Tanakh that what? God's name is not there. So why did Ezra call Babylonian names to the months? In the Tanakh, it's not Tammuz. It's called Chodesh HaRishon, Chodesh HaSheni, Chodesh HaShlishi. This is Chodesh HaRevi. Why did Ezra substitute Babylonian names, Avram? Why?
To remind us?
Because the Gemara in Ksubis says, I think it's in my handwriting, the Gemara in Ksubis, Taf Kuf Yud, Kol Adar B'chutz La'aretz, Kimi She'en Lo Yelahai. Ksubis, page 110, says, anyone who lives in Shmutz La'aretz is like he has no God. Kol She'en Adar B'Eretz Yisrael. The Gemara goes on, anyone that does not live in Eretz Yisrael, Ein Lo Yelahai. It's like he has no God. The Kol Adar B'chutz La'aretz, Ilu Ovet Avodazara. Therefore, the month is called Tammuz. That's a knas. How do you say knas in English?
A penalty.
A penalty. Ezra was penalizing the Jewish people. You like Shmutz Laret so much, and whoever lives in Chutz Laret is like worships idols, we're going to call the month by an idol. Because you live in Chutz Laret, it's like you worship idols anyway. A reminder of the shame that Mashiach could have come 2,400 years ago. And there would be no Shoah. That's what the Gemara says over here. Right? The Jews would have come, the Second Temple wouldn't have been destroyed, no Shoah. But they remained behind, and therefore the Second Temple, Avram, was doomed from destruction from the get-go, and therefore Ezra penalized the Jewish people by substituting Chodesh HaRishon, Chodesh HaSheni, Chodesh HaShlishi with what? With Babylonian names and even the name of an idol to shame us. The opportunity that you lost that you could have had. Because whoever lives outside of Israel is like worshiping idols. How do they learn this in Tinek? It's a Gemara Ksubis page 110 side B. Whoever lives in Chutz Laretz is like he worships idols. Very extreme statement. But that's what the Gemara says. So therefore, the Jews wanted to remain behind in Chutz Laretz. So as a knas, Ezra substituted what? Babylonian pagan names to remind the Jews of their shame. You look at the bottom. I think there's an arrow there. 1 second. Is there an arrow there?
Yeah.
You see that? No arrow. Unfortunately, the Yeshua Eretz Yisrael is not a chumrah, because then all the borough parkers would make aliyah. Alas, it's only a mitzvah, Avram. It's not a chumrah. Get it? Mm. Now, the Sifri says that school of mitzvahs, yeshivas, Eretz Yisrael, keneged kol mitzvah shebetorah. The Sifri says that the mitzvah of living in Israel equals in weight like all the other mitzvahs. See the bottom of the page, Chav, in my handwriting? Yes. See the pischei tshuva? Everybody holds from the pischei tshuva. Misnagdim, Svardim, Ashkenazim. You see pischei tshuva in the bottom?
Yes.
No? Evan Ezra, Simon, Ayin, Hay. Sha'af bezman hazeh. I think there are arrows there. No, is there an arrow there?
Yeah.
The arrows pointing in two different directions?
Right, yeah.
Like Yogi Berra said, if you come to a fork in the road,
take it.
Professor, I have pointing two different things. So the Pischei Tshuva, Avram, written in the 1700s, whether you're Ashkenazi, whether you're Svardi, Chusid, Misnagit, everybody holds from the Pischei Tshuva. And he says in Evan Ezra, Simon, Ayin, Hay, that the mitzvah to live in Israel equals all the other mitzvahs combined. Af bezman hazeh. What does af bezman hazeh mean?
Even right now.
So Mindel, thanks. We have to buy one, get 613. Jews love bargains. Buy one, get 613.
Yeah.
Wow. So the question is, why is living in Chutz Laretz, why is it like worshiping Avodah Zarah? Why? The Ramban explains. You look in the book of Daniel, all of the nations of the world, HaKadosh Baruch Hu puts a heavenly minister in charge. Yiddish? God uses heavenly angels to administer to the nations of the world. He chooses to do that. Why he chooses? We don't know. The only nation that doesn't have a heavenly minister in charge of it is what?
Israel.
Eretz Yisrael. Over here it's a local call, Evelyn. Here is a direct relationship. But throughout the world, you look in the book of Daniel, says Ramban, HaKadosh Baruch Hu puts heavenly angels in charge of each country. So if you're praying to God, who intercepts the prayers? The angel. It looks like you're praying to the angel. That's classic idolatry, even though you're not praying to the angel. But the angel's intercepting your prayers because God put him in charge of that country. So it's like you're worshiping an angel, which is classic idolatry, even though you're not. The only country that has no angel in charge is Eretz Yisrael.
Right.
Here, direct relationship with Hashem. So anyway, I don't know how they get around this Gemara in Babylon, Long Island, but anyway, that's what it says. So therefore, as an eternal shame, we have these Persian Babylonian names. When Mashiach comes, and all the Jews will be forced to make Aliyah, it won't be called Tammuz no more. It'll be called what? Yudah, Chodesh Revi. We're going to go back to the future. The shame and the stigma will be removed. But until then, we continue to call the month Tammuz to remind us of what could have been. The opportunity that we had and we lost, the Jews would have come back, the Second Temple never would have been destroyed, there would have been no Holocaust. But in the Torah, the month is called Chodesh Revi Avram. So the Ramban tells us when Mashiach comes, we're going to go back to the old system when the Tikkun will have made. But until then, we have the shame and stigma of referring to the month by Babylonian names, and perhaps that's one reason to fast next Sunday, Avram. Shiva Sabatamuz, that we have to name a fast after a Babylonian idol. The Jews continue to have this love affair with Schmutzlorets. It's frightening, right? That they just can't let go, right? That they love Chutzlorets, and that is the, and they say now America is the new what? As you see here on the second page, America is our home. That's what J Street said, the AJC. And that attitude, that's a dangerous attitude, Avram. Yeah. To think that you what, that we're not in exile anymore. Right? The Jews think they're not in exile anymore. When Jews get too comfortable in Schmutzlorets, what happens? What happens?
They're
going to remind them.
The Zohar says America's going to sink.
Yeah,
that's what the Zohar says.
But the Vilna Gaon says Mashiach cannot come unless the majority of world Jewry come to Eretz Israel. You look at the Pat HaShulchan. One of his Talmidim wrote that Mashiach, people say in Borough Park, they're waiting for Mashiach. But according to Vilna Gaon, Mashiach is what?
Waiting for them.
Mashiach cannot come until the majority of world Jewry makes Aliyah. So every Jew that makes Aliyah, Professor, Yiddle by Yiddle, I mean little by little, Yiddle by Yiddle, every Jew that makes Aliyah, according to the Vilna Gaon, is bringing the Mashiach one step closer. Right? But some people say, don't confuse me with the fact, we're waiting for Mashiach. Mashiach is waiting for you. So that's why we call the month Tammuz. This is a knas that Ezra imposed on the Jewish people. And not only did he impose that, but if you look at the Gemara in Gittin, Yehuda, he penalized the Kohanim and the Levites. He took away the Miser from the Levites. He penalized them. Levites are supposed to get Miser. But because they refused to come up, he took away their Miser from them. You guys don't deserve Miser because you like Bavel over Pisgat Zev. And Rav Soloveitchik points out something incredible. In Eretz Yisrael, at my shul, you can have 19 Kohanim and you won't even have one Levi. There's a phenomenon in Eretz Yisrael. In Avraham, how many Levim you have in your shul?
More than Kohanim.
Levim in your shul? I think you're an exception. How many Levim you have, Dr. Hackett, in your shul? Levim, not talking Kohanim. Avraham, how many Levim in my shul and in my Pisgat Zev, you can't find even a half a Levi in 9 shuls. What's it all about, says Rav Soloveitchik. Yehuda comes, he doubles the amount. He's the Levi, queen, Levi for a day. You remember Queen for a day? He's the Levi. Why is there no Levium, so little Levium in Eretz Yisrael? Says Rav Soloveitchik, this is a result because they refused to come up with Ezra.
Well, the Kohanim.
And therefore, Kohanim more came. But the Levites, nobody came. Kohanim a trickle came, at least some came. But the Levites were totally out to lunch. And therefore, there's so little Levium in Eretz Yisrael today. And therefore, Ezra took away their Miser, that they don't get Miser anymore. But this is the Jewish psychosis. I think it's called the DNA syndrome, Avram, Dossam Aviram syndrome. Rav Soloveitchik asked the question. The Torah is GPS, Avram, God's personal system. Dossam Aviram, What do they say? They refer to Cairo as Eretz Zavas Cholof Udvash. They refer to the land of Egypt as a land flowing with milk and honey. Such an ugly anti-Israel statement. The statement that God uses to praise Israel, they use that statement to praise America. I mean, to praise Egypt. So why does the Torah have to record it for? The Torah's GPS, Rafsavetchik asked the question, they said it, they're anti-Israel, they hate Israel, they love Egypt, Chutz Laretz. Why record their statement? Said Rafsavetchik, that the Dosa Maviram syndrome is alive and well. He said this in 1956. You hear this? He says that there's a Jewish psychosis that the Jews reject the land of Israel and want to blend in with the Goyim. It's not an isolated affair. The Dosa Maviram syndrome is destined to haunt the Jewish people throughout a long and bitter exile. But the Torah writes it not to despair. The Gula will come despite J Street. The Gula will come despite those so-called Hasidic Jews who slander Israel in Nassau Coliseum. And to give us courage, says Asavetchik, the Dosa Maviram could not stop the first Gula, and they won't be able to stop the final Gula as well. And so the Torah writes about it, that we have to know there is such a Jewish psychosis of self-hatred and hating the land of Israel, but the Gula will come anyway. Don't despair, Chava, hang in there. Therefore, the DNA syndrome is recorded for posterity. So says the great Rav Soloveitchik. Because the Torah just tells me what I need to know for the year 2018. Do we have the DNA today? Dosam Yaviram, it's J Street. It's also those so-called Hasidim who rented out the Nassau Coliseum.
Right.
They're also Dosam Yaviram, even though they were Eshtreimel. Or the AJC, 47% reject Israel, reject Jerusalem as a capital. The survey last week, Yehuda, thanks to you, I read it. American Jewish Committee, 47% of United States Jews oppose the U.S. Embassy move to Jerusalem and do not recognize Jerusalem as a capital.
Unbelievable.
Isn't that the Dosa Maviram syndrome?
But Rabbi, what about...
But don't despair, Masha. The Mashiach will come.
But what about...
Don't despair.
...that are here...
No.
...that also doesn't be our root. That's also
right.
Against us on
you mean,
our country. We have all these Jews here in Israel that are...
There are none so blind as those who won't see. How could you live in Israel, Avraham, not making Sheberach for the Chayalim? I don't understand that.
I know.
Could you live in this country a minute without the Chayalim? The Haredim should kiss the feet of the Chayalim. How could you not make a Mishaberach for the Chayalim, Avram? You also make a Mishaberach for the Chayalim, Avram? They do, Baruch Hashem. The whole Yahadut, Sherry, the Sefer Chinuch and Rabbeinu Bechai said that Judaism rests on the principle of Hakaras HaTov. How do you say that in English? Hakaras HaTov.
Recognize the good.
Acknowledge, appreciate the good someone does you.
Thankfulness.
How could you not acknowledge the good of the Chayalim? How could you live and study Torah without the Chayalim? How could you not make a Mishabera for them? It just doesn't enter my little mind. And not to make a Mishabera for the Chayalim? Avram said, for the Tsar, they make a Mishabera. In Russia, they made a Mishabera for the Tsar. Right? Remember Fiddle on the Roof? Rabbi, is there a blessing for the Tsar? May God keep the Tsar far away from us. So for the Tsar, they make a blessing. But for the state of Israel, Masha, forget about it. Is that sick?
Totally.
For the Tsar, then.
I agree.
No, I just don't understand it. I just don't understand. Can you explain it to me?
I wish.
People are so stuck in their ways.
What?
To let the fetch
I just don't understand it.
You know, even Rabbi Kahana said that he, I read Barbara Ginsburg dragged up he had two letters come in the same week. One from a religious man in Illinois, from like Chicago area, I guess, and a nationalist secular from Israel.
Right.
Both of whom said that, you gotta leave us alone,
Don't bother us.
Religious guy says, try to make us better Jews where we are.
And Schmutzlaritz.
And Schmutzlaritz, and the nationalist from Israel, at Hebrew University, said, try to make these things include everybody, include the non-religious, please.
Mm-hmm.
So there you go.
But anyway, we have to convince our friends and family to make Aliyah. Because every Jew that makes Aliyah, according to Vilna Gaon, he was Haredi, brings the Mashiach one step closer. Shalom, Vilna Gaon said this. Look in the Parat HaShulchan, written by his Talmud. He says that every Jew that makes Aliyah is bringing the Mashiach one step closer. And by definition, the other side of the coin, every Jew that doesn't make Aliyah is what?
Stopping.
Is preventing the Mashiach from coming. The Vilna Gaon. He tried to come here. He got shipwrecked by pirates. His Talmidim came here. In 1802, before Herzl, his Talmidim came here, right, Dr. Hackett? 1802. So therefore, you have the Yerushalayim goes according to the Minhag HaGra.
All the Riplins.
But doesn't it say in the Torah that God's going to bring us all back when Mashiach comes?
God only helps those who help themselves. Avram, who said that? Deuteronomy 14:29. I'm not joking. You can look it up when you get home. Devarim 14:29. You can look
it
up, you know.
That
God only helps those who help themselves. You're going to sit like this. Forget about it.
Was he captured by pirates?
He was captured and they had a ransom, the whole story, Mendel. But he tried to come here. He couldn't make it. He got shipwrecked and they had ransom. But his Talmidim did make it here. In 1802, right?
Yahoo.
The original Zionists, right? Yes? Any questions, comments? So, Baruch Hashem, you have the schus to come here, to be here, and we should appreciate every moment that we live here, that according to the Pesachei Tshuva, Eben Ezer, living in Israel, Abraham, buy one, get 613. Jews love bargains. Mitzvah, Shrichas, Kavanah. Thank you very much.